Can we get even more performance out of this ROG Ally by repasting the Z1 Extreme? Let's test it out.
Let's fire it up. Let's fire it up. Okay. Let's fire it up. I didn't unplug anything.
Hey PC World fans, Adam here, and I have an ROG Ally with the Z1 Extreme chip in it. And I had a question that popped into my mind recently was, would repasting get us more performance out of the ROG Ally? You can get some great gains by repasting a Steam Deck, but the ROG Ally cooling solution is already more beefy than the actual Steam Deck. So I was curious, can we actually get even more by repasting it? Or is what's already in here good enough? So I don't know, let's go down this journey, try it out. First step is to run a couple benchmarks with the old school paste job applied. So let's go ahead and launch Steam and launch Cyberpunk 2077. All right, I've launched Cyberpunk 2077. Let's go ahead and go into the settings. I'm going to pick the Steam Deck preset. Unfortunately, the Steam Deck preset sets the FSR 2.1 to auto. I don't want that variable to change, so I'm actually gonna hit balanced on that and then apply. Go down and apply. On the video tab, I have it set to 1080p with VSync off, so we see the theoretical max of what we can do. Let's go ahead and run the benchmark, and I have MSI Afterburner open up here to go ahead and check the temperatures, because obviously this benchmark doesn't have a built-in temperature readout. So let's let this benchmark run and see what we get. All right, the benchmark is done, and it's telling us we're getting an average of 30 FPS, that smooth 30. And I was watching the temperature on the GPU specifically, and it maxed out around 80°C, but it was mostly hovering around 77 or 78°C. So we have at least one variable here. I'm gonna go ahead and run this benchmark again, just to double check the numbers. So after three runs, we have an average FPS of smooth 30, thanks Steam Deck preset. And the GPU, which I was watching on MSI Afterburner, was hanging around 73, 74°C. I will say this was at the turbo operating mode, which is at operating at 25 watts. The first run, interesting enough, was boosting up to 30 watts, and I was seeing about 80°C. But it settled down to 25 watts and we're getting about 74°C. So let's switch over to a different game and get at least one more benchmark. So now I've fired up Horizon Zero Dawn. Let's go into the settings. I've it set to 1080p with no upscaling and the refresh rate to 120Hz, VSync off, and the graphics set to original. So let's go ahead and run this benchmark. It's gonna take a little longer, so I think it's gonna heat up even more potentially than Cyberpunk, but we'll come back and see. All right, so I was actually wrong. I was watching the GPU temperatures and it was hanging around the same place as Cyberpunk, 72, 73, 74, something like that. So yeah, actually not too bad. And we got an average FPS of 35. So I actually don't know if we're gonna get any more performance out of doing a repaste job, but maybe we can get it to run a little bit cooler. Well, let's just try it out. So the first things first is to actually shut the damn thing off. All right, I got my handy dandy screwdriver and let's open this up. Now I have opened it once during our live stream hands-on review thingy when I first got it. But I have not opened it up since, and I have not taken out the cooling solution with the heat pipe and the fans. So hopefully I don't break anything, but we'll see how it goes. I don't think these ones are gonna come out. Hey, oh, got it. Got my little pry tool. There we go.
Is that a pry tool or is it a guitar pick?
This is not a guitar pick, but that would be funny if iFixit started making guitar picks. All right, so we have the inside of the ROG Ally. I am going to disconnect the battery just in case. You don't have to, but...
Not usually. You don't want to electrocute it.
I mean, it wouldn't shock me. See if I can wiggle this out without breaking it. Maybe I don't. There we go. Okay, so I did the safe thing and disconnected the battery. So we got this little flap that obviously we got access to the SSD, but really I want to get under here. That's where that APU is. So I'm just going to take that off, leave it over here. And it looks like there's just 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 screws. So let's go for those. All right, so I'm gonna back this off slowly with even amounts of pressure. Another tamper-proof sticker. Whoops, you got me.
I'm sweating here, Adam. Just looking at you.
Oh, you go. Oh, it's fine. What, you just worried about the sticker? Cops aren't coming. All right, I think this might be. Yeah. Hear a little click, so these must be captive. At least I'm hoping. All right, let's see. See if I can just take this out. Oh, there we go. There we go. Oh, am I missing a screw? Feels like it's caught on something. Oh, no, I just need to wiggle it out. There you go. And like that, we're free. You know what? It looks like the fans are attached. Yeah, the fans are attached here, this cable. So I need to peel up this sticker here. Just gonna put it here for safekeeping. That's a good spot.
So you're playing operations.
Yeah, operation. Don't get buzzed. Pull out that fan header, do the same thing over here. Got that little fan header. Just gonna grab the plastic and wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. There we go. Now the whole thing should be loose. And, all right. So you can see there's a thermal paste. It's not a heaping amount. I like to really glob it on, so I'll probably make a mess more than this, but I mean, it looks even enough. But let's see if we can do better. So let's clean it off. I've got my Arctic cleaner. Just gonna wipe off the excess first. Okay, it's a good amount. There's no writing on the actual die itself. You can see it says a Z1 Extreme off to the side here, but that's a nice big APU. That's definitely bigger than what's in the Steam Deck, I believe. All right, I'm gonna use a little bit of Arctic cleaner to clean it off. Put some here, put some here. If I'm doing it wrong, blame Gordon. He's the one who taught me how to clean thermal paste. All right, so, I mean, there's still a little bit off the edge, but yeah, whatever, it's fine. Clean enough. So next, I'm gonna apply some new thermal paste. So the thermal paste that I've seen a lot of people use for the Steam Deck is this Thermalright TF. It's very thick, very viscous. So that's what I'm gonna use for this. I didn't test anything. I'm not A/B testing which kind of thermal paste is best for it. I'm just gonna go ahead and try this one and see if this works. So here we go. Let's do a nice size glob right in the middle. Bleep.
How many cc's of thermal paste is that?
2600 cc stat. All right, let's spread this nice and even. And boy, you can tell how thick that is. It's like putty.
You're painting like Bob Ross. Yeah. Just a little happy tree here, happy tree there.
Just a little happy thermal paste. A little happy thermal paste. Oh yeah, nice and thick.
nice and thick, evenly spread. Okay, all right, I think that's good enough. All right, cool. Then I guess we now, at this point, reverse the steps, which means I gotta plug these fans back in without getting all the thermal paste. You know what, actually, can I do it with, I should just plug them in beforehand. Let's go ahead and plug them in. The time when you need steady, delicate hands, and I have neither. Ah, oh, this is the hardest part of the whole thing. I cannot get this. Oh man, this video is just gonna be 20 minutes of me.
Oh, this is where I'm going to insert some, you know, suspenseful music.
Oh my goodness. It's gotta be easier to do this. There we go. There we go, we did it.
Woohoo! Heard that click.
Yeah, all right. So now, let's tape this down. Yeah, sure. Good enough. All right. Now, here we go. Actually, I think I need to. I'm gonna hook the fans underneath before I. All right, so one fan's in. There we go, okay. Hooked it under that little tab. Hook this one under the little tab. And there we go. I did it. Nice. Now let's evenly screw it in. If this is an application for assembly line work, I think I would be passed up for the job.
Not fast enough, Adam.
Not fast enough. Too sloppy. Too many mistakes. All right, let's screw in the fans. All right, I think it's right. Feels secure. Yeah, all right. Cool, now let's plug the battery back in. And put this little shield over it. I think it went something like that. There we go, something like that. There we go. Now let's put the back on. And screwed in. And last one. There we go. I think they are all nice and tight. All right, cool. Now, let's fire it up and hopefully it doesn't melt. Let's fire it up. Let's fire it up. Okay. Let's fire it up.
Hello.
I didn't unplug anything. Did I plug the battery all the way back in?
I was gonna say, yeah, is it all the way?
I'm gonna plug it into a power. It might just need a little kickstart. Oh, there. Okay, so it sees the battery. There we go. Okay. Woo-wee. Woo. That was that's okay. Hey, you know, it's all part of the job.
What happened, Adam?
It wasn't turning on, but now I got it to turn on. Look at that. Woo. But now let's make sure it doesn't melt itself. Yeah, I don't smell anything. Don't smell anything burning. Not yet, at least. All right. Hey, it booted up. All right, let's start up Steam. Start up MSI Afterburner. I'm going to unplug power. And we are still in 25-watt turbo mode. Let's go ahead and launch Cyberpunk, not Spiderpunk, Cyberpunk. So I did let the Ally warm up for about 20 minutes just to make sure it's nice and toasty in there. Even with the testing that we had done earlier, because it was kind of sitting there idling. So I wanted to be fair. Let's go in and make sure we're on the Steam Deck preset, FSR 2.1 set to balanced. Everything's set there. Let's go ahead and apply it. And then over to video, VSync is off. 1920 by 1080, full screen, yada yada. All right, let's go ahead and run the benchmark and see if it's cooler or faster. Oh yeah, see, now it's hitting 80, 82. Uh-oh,
even hotter. And so after the first run, it was actually still boosting up to 30 watts, so I'm going to run it a couple more times, but I did notice it was actually getting a little warmer, so it was about 81, 82 compared to that first run when it was boosting to 30 watts, but it did turn in 3 frames faster, so a little hotter and 3 extra frames. Woohoo, I did it. Let's go ahead and run it again. Let's burn off this boost and have it settle down to 25 watts and see what we get then. Oh, 32. Okay, huh. Well, interesting enough, this is the third run, and it settled down to 25 watts through that whole run, and I did see temperatures just a little bit higher, but about 2 to 3 degrees higher, but we got 2 extra frames. So I guess it's kind of a win. Let's switch over to Horizon Zero Dawn and see if we get any sort of performance gains over there. All right, we're in Horizon Zero Dawn. Let's go to the settings, double check, 1080p, 120 hertz, no upscaling, and original quality. Let's go ahead and run the benchmark. All right, so we see the same result, 35 FPS. I was watching the temperature and it was slightly higher, I would say 1 degree maybe. So instead of 74, it was kind of peaking at 75, but it was mostly hanging around in 74. So not really any different on Horizon Zero Dawn. So, did it work? Well, yes, it worked. I was able to put it back successfully. But in Horizon Zero Dawn, we didn't see any change. If anything, maybe just a little warmer, but it's in margin of error, I think. In Cyberpunk, we definitely saw a change. So with the original paste, the second time I ran the Cyberpunk benchmark, it actually did not boost up to 30. It settled down at that 25 watts. And that was the same thing for the third benchmark. After I repasted it, that second run actually held at that 30 watts for that entire run. Once again, it was a little bit warmer, but it held that boost for that second run. And then the third run is when it settled back down into 25 watts. So what I'm thinking is that, yes, it's able to actually allow the processor to get a little hotter because it's able to wick away the heat a little bit more effectively, which is leading to higher temperatures. It's feeling like it can sustain those higher temperatures and sustain that boost for a little bit longer. But all we saw was about 3 frames. So a 10% increase in Cyberpunk. But on the flip side, I didn't see any sort of gain in Horizon. If anything, we got a little bit of warmer temperatures, but no increase in frame rates. So what I will say is that it kind of points to the fact that Asus did a good job designing the Ally. We already knew that it was better than the solution that was in the Steam Deck. It's definitely quieter, for sure. So I would say props to Asus. Repasting it is not making a huge difference. So I think that's, if you want to look at it another way, it's like, oh wow, okay, well it's doing its job as intended the first time, and that is something to be rewarded for sure. So was it easy to take apart and apply new thermal paste? Yes. The benefit I got from it was just not as apparent. Is it worth doing? I don't know. I'm just happy I put it together and it's working again. It is not smelling like anything's burning. So yeah, I guess I'm curious to see if anybody out there has tried to repaste the ROG Ally, because who knows, maybe you used a different kind of paste and it worked better. Maybe you used less than I did. I don't know. I'm curious to see if anyone else has done it and seen drastic results. If so, let me know in the comments. And while you're there, be sure to subscribe here at PC World for more PC hardware and software goodness. We will catch you in the next one. Bye. Smells like gaming.